How do you feel about this new PARCC decision where 30% of the evaluation of a teacher is going to come down to how well their students do in a test?
Absolutely absurd. Absolutely absurd. I wish we could pay Chris Christie based on his approval rating. That's kind of the equivalent.
You know what? That's
Chris
a good comparison.
His approval rating. You know, it's his way of keeping a test in and keeping people paid to provide a test. And we have to do it. And as I said before, it is academic. It's educational extortion. He's extorting schools into administering this test. And he's basically saying, if you don't, your school's not getting money. And that's what it comes down to. We have so many great kids who need so much more than tests in their lives. And it's like you're forcing teachers to not care about kids. And again, you're a parent. How would you feel if your teacher could care less about your daughter and your daughter's going through stuff, but every day they're basically telling your children and not that their emotions don't matter, that their emotional instability, they could care less. They need them to study to do well on a test. And that's what it's forcing teachers to do.
Yeah, it's totally desensitizing. And, you know, I have a relationship with our teachers that teach our children. They email us, you know, we know what's going on. I can go talk to them anytime. I see what you put up on Twitter all the time about, you know, the teachers that were an influence. People remember all the way back. You put your kindergarten teacher up there, you know, that, you know, you know who the biggest influences in your life are. And this is going to take away from that because people aren't going to remember. They're just going to know what they did in a test.
Well, it's funny because Marvin Harrison was just inducted into the Hall of Fame. The first person he thanked was his high school teacher who spent every day with him after school mentoring him, taking care of him. And his teacher was sitting right there, and he said, without you, I would have never made it through high school nor college.
That's what's getting missed here.
Yeah, and to me, it's like you can't evaluate that in a teacher evaluation. How can you evaluate that teachers are paying for kids to eat or helping them out or mentoring them or giving them emotional stability or caring about them? Where's caring in the evaluation? You can't, because you can't factor that.
Nor can you factor the conditions of the kids or what's going on in their lives that are causing them to get these test scores.
And to me, you know, kids are smart. It's almost a great way to blackmail a teacher. Basically saying, you know what? Hey, you better be nice to us. We're not going to do all this test and you're going to get fired. You know, it's a very interesting dynamic. And the other irony, the biggest irony, is there is not a single piece of data that links student success to this test.
No, not at all.
Some of the smartest people in history were very bad test takers. Well, the irony is we're told to teach each child differently because they are, yet we're then testing them identically the same, which they're not. So it's one of the bizarre ironies. It's almost like we're telling each kid to train differently at a different sport, but we're all testing them on throwing the football. So it's like it's really bizarre, and it's really destroying education, and it is forcing teachers and people not going to education. It's forcing amazing teachers to retire because of the paperwork, the data analysis that we have to do.
And others not even want to become teachers.
They're turning us into filing cabinets. You know, there's very little time for professional development and teacher collaboration. They're turning teachers into file cabinets. We have to collect data. We're statisticians, not educators.